Hey, what's going on, y'all? So in this video, we're going to be taking a look at FaceGood facial animation. Now, I'm doing a little bit of experiment right now. As y'all know, the FaceGood camera can only shoot 30 frames per second. So what I ended up doing was I bought the Topaz Video Enhance AI because they have this feature where you can change the frames per second using AI from 30 to 60 to 120. So what I did was just I went ahead and took a 30 frames per second and I outputted it to 120 frames per second. This video right here was shot with the FaceGood camera, the D2 that I have. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to load this up in the Avatary software, which is the FaceGood software. And then we're gonna try and animate this in Maya using the MetaHumans. So if you've seen my previous video before, it's pretty similar what we're about to do. Cause right now I'm just kind of doing some R&D. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to my tracker right here. Okay, so let's go ahead and load up that file. And I know I get a lot of questions about this process here. So I'm gonna go ahead and go right here. And here's the video, the 120 frames per second converted using the Topaz. And I'm gonna press, I'm gonna name this tutorial 2. And I'm gonna go ahead and press plus. And I'm gonna use the AI number 3. And I'm gonna create a project right here. And what I'll do next is just auto track this. I'm not gonna do it manually, because I think it does a pretty good job at auto-tracking it, even though manual is still better. So let's go ahead and go to auto-track right here. And this is gonna take a minute or so. Okay, so now that's finished. If I go to the mouth right here, you're gonna see that this is actually gonna track the mouth movement right here. I stay pretty still right there. And then once I start opening my mouth, you know, it looks pretty good. Although I wish I can kind of move these right here. But whenever I do right now, Jello, if you're watching this, bro, whenever I do move these in the right spot and then I track again using it right here, it loses everything else. So maybe let me know why that's causing that. But for the most part, the auto tracker is pretty good. And as you can see in the brows as well, it's doing pretty good as far as tracking it. And I'm going to play it because to me, it looks pretty good. Like, I've shot 120 frames per second before. Now, although it is not native, I think it did a pretty good job at converting it to 120. So I'm going to go ahead and go to export this to a targeter. All right. And they did fix this, which is really nice. It doesn't, like, usually you get the not responding thing, but it looks like they fixed it, which is awesome. Target again. I'm going to save this here. And now you get this export retarget over, so that's good, so I can close this. So what I'll do next is open up Avatary again, and I'm going to open up my retargeter right here, which is going to open up Maya 2019, which is the version I have. Okay, and then in here, I just have a MetaHuman that I saved, so I'm going to open it. I just downloaded it straight from Bridge, and I saved it into a new file. So let's go ahead and do that, and I think I have it in the desktop, Avatar Test, and I have it as Zion MB right here. Okay, so we have this MetaHuman here now that we just opened again straight from Bridge. And let me just go ahead and make sure that the preferences is set correctly. This is... Yusuf. I don't like your Maya, dude. I don't like it at all. So it's already set at DirectX 11, so I'm gonna go ahead and close this and open it back up because there is a bug right now that does this. Okay, it looks like it's actually loading now. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. This is good. All right, so let's go ahead and open up FaceGood right here, the retargeter. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to go ahead and import that retargeter. FaceGood, tracker, projects, and it should be target again. All right, perfect. So I'm going to change this to 120 frames per second because that's what the video is. And I'm going to go ahead and change the time. I don't know why it defaults to 5. It doesn't make any sense, man. I swear, Maya is like weird. Never seen anything default to not 0. So right here, we have the FaceGood retargeter, and I already have the controllers here. Again, if you haven't seen my first tutorial, go ahead and check it out. I'm gonna have the tutorial con, but pretty much we are selecting all the controllers on a rig and adding them into different groups. So you can see the brow, the eye, the mouth. So that's good. And additionally, whenever you open the FaceGood retargeter, something comes out right here. And let me go ahead and fix this. Rotate it 90 degrees. And then we will load that video here. So go to the folder, and it should be in my desktop called Inquiry. And that should be it. And let's go ahead and move it a little bit. It's actually not 100, not 90. So let's go ahead right there. So it's good. Okay, so I'm not gonna worry about the brow in the eye, because that's pretty easy to do. Like, eyes, I was looking straight and the brow just goes up and down. So I usually work on the mouth first, because this is what I want to do pretty much all my practice in whenever I'm doing this. Go ahead and move that a little bit. Okay, so on the pose tab, after you click the mouth, which selects again all the controllers for this mouth right here, I'm gonna go ahead and update one for the neutral, and that's gonna add a keyframe right here. And I'm gonna pick all of the extreme poses. See, that's pretty extreme. Update. And again, there is some ROM procedures that you can do. FaceGood has a picture that shows you the stuff that you can do, which I asked permission for. I'm gonna make a tutorial about it later whenever they say it's okay to share, but they have their own ROM procedure. Okay, so that's pretty extreme. And that's extreme. Now, I'm clearly making a lot of extreme faces right now, obviously, for the sake of this video. And then I'm gonna talk regularly. All right, so just kind of go through that. And again, you can mark as many as you want. This is kind of extreme right there, so let's do an update. And there is a smile with only the top part showing. You can also do that. We do have this bite lip, and I'm gonna choose 7. Just like this, and then we'll move on. So I'm gonna go to 0, and I'm going to go ahead and press update, and that's gonna turn green. The whole point is get all the reds to turn green. So I'm gonna go to this, and it's gonna snap to that extreme pose, and you guessed it, what we're gonna do is actually try and copy that on the MetaHuman itself. Now, this is what takes practice, and this is why I'm here kind of like every other day or so. I would just go here and start messing around with things, because this control board is insane. This is, again, one of the best things about MetaHumans is they have such good control rigs and animation tools as far as animating the face. This is a really robust control rig right here. So for that face right there, probably just like an open mouth. Again, you can play around with this if you want. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that right there, and that's pretty good, but this lower, I think I must have did that wrong one. Let's try the top one. It's kind of like a kind of like that. And maybe a little bit wider, because it's pretty extreme, and I did it purposely like that. So that's my ah right there. And I know you can't see the teeth, but I think I need to start shooting the video with the mouth a little bit higher so you can kind of see it like that. So we will open it up just a little bit more. And additionally, you can see my face kind of looks skinnier. We can try to mimic that if you want. If you go right here, you can kind of like extend it a little bit in the middle. Maybe not so much as far as the face goes. Like that. So it's just a little bit of, you know, stretching on the side there. Let's do the before and after. Just a little bit, like it's yelling. Now, whenever I'm happy with this, I would just go click update, and that's gonna turn green. Go to the next one. Now, this is hard. This is actually really hard. Like, this is how I was able to do this pose right here. If you know a better way, then please do let me know. But this is pretty much how I did this one. I mean, I think that's just the way my lip is, to be honest. I don't think people actually does that. So I'm gonna go ahead, go like this, a little bit higher. Might actually turn these off. Yeah, that's pretty good. Let's go ahead and click update. Go to number 3. This is a cheesy smile here. Super cheesy smile. This should be an easy one to do. I think I kind of made that crooked. So we got this. Should be this one. There you go. Just a little bit of higher. Kind of like so. And it looks like I do have a little bit of, like so. And then I can open it just a little bit. You can kind of see my teeth just barely touching there. And if you want to tweak it a little bit more, I mean, that's pretty close. And I'm gonna update that right there. And then we have this O shape. Now, let's see if I can copy this. Should be a funnel, actually. It's actually fun. It's like again, I just kind of do this like every now and then just to kind of practice because I want to learn this control rig. So it would kind of just be like, you know, second nature for me to do all of this without having to do a lot. And that's really the best way to do it is just come in here and just do crazy faces and practice. Practice makes perfect, man. So that's kind of like pretty close. I'm going to move this a little bit higher. There you go. Update. Let's go to the next one. The next one is this kind of like similar. It's pretty similar. You just see a little bit of teeth like that. So that's good. And let's move it down up a little bit and then move it again with the teeth and stuff. And we have that smile, but really this is the top. So let's see if I can mimic that. And let's see the bottom here. Yep. Like so. That's pretty darn good. I might have done it too much. Just tone it down a little bit. All right. Update. Actually, I might probably open that just a little bit. And I'm going to hide the lip just a little bit because you can see right here, I didn't really have too much. So I'm going to go ahead and update. And then go to the last post. This is an easy one. This is bite lip. So that's right there. You know, sometimes I do hate where this control is because I hit that thing a lot. And here's the bite lip. This one's easy. Gonna just max it out on the bite lip and update. Now, this is the magic of FaceGood, right? I marked 7. And once I'm done marking, I can press start. Okay. And now if I press play. All right. And I'm gonna go rewind all the way to 0 first. That's pretty crazy. I marked 7 extreme poses, and what it's doing is actually creating keyframes in between for the entire animation. And this is the power of deep learning AI, because we didn't even take that long to get that facial animation, and I did a pretty darn bad job, I think, with the control rig. So this is the potential of this kind of technology. And I know I get a lot of questions of, do you need an infrared camera to make this work? No, you don't. My first time using Avatari with Jello, I sent him my DIY action camera video and he was able to work that with his team. So you don't need an infrared camera. One of the best things about having an infrared camera is you don't have to worry about lights in front of your face. I am gonna be trying a DIY light situation here shortly whenever I get it, and I'll make another video because my action camera has 120 frames per second. So I'm thinking I might be able to use my DIY helmet again to get higher frames per second in exchange for the infrared, because right now, like I said, the FaceGood D2 only shoots 30 frames per second, and ideal 120 frames per second is probably the best you can get. So I'm still kind of playing around with it. My DIY helmet is a lot heavier than FaceGood's helmet, but you do get that native 120 frames per second, even though it's not infrared. Best case scenario, one day we will have, hopefully, a FaceGood 120 frames per second infrared camera. That's best case scenario. But for now, I'm going to be using the D2 or maybe my DIY again. But that's pretty much it. That is how you use FaceGood. This is more like part 2. If you haven't seen part 1, go ahead, because I go in a little bit more detail than that. But I just wanted to make another video because a lot of people are asking me about this. This is how the facial animation was done with my recent Cyberpunk short film, Zin, and my interview short film, This is the same exact method using Facegood Avatari. Now, Avatari is free with certain limitations, so you can download it in facegood.cc to play around with it, but you do have a little bit of limitations in there as far as exporting and stuff like that. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, if you want me to keep making Unreal Engine content, please do like and subscribe this video. I am trying to get to 50,000 subscribers so I can go ahead and give away a full body motion capture device with a short film contest, which I think is pretty cool.